Despite everything that's been said and done about transportation network companies or TNCs, questions still remain. Who is accountable in case of accidents involving TNCs like Grab and Uber? Are their charges reasonable? The Senate Committee on Public Services wants to see improvements in the regulation of these ride-sharing companies. In a hearing of the committee, both Grab and Uber say their driver partners are required to have government-mandated insurance, which covers passengers up to 200,000 pesos in case of accident. Grab says all their accredited drivers undergo mandatory drug testing. Uber drivers do not.
That's a problem, no, ma'am. And that's why I do agree, no, that this is a new technology, but it's imbued with public interest.
Senator Wynne Gatchalian raises concern about the hours drivers spent on the road.
There's no regulation for that. Sir.
But usually it's between 12 to 16 hours. Dahil in driving a day, meron mga, there are times na madaming pasero, may mga times na nawalang pasero.
Bong Suntay, president of Philippine National Taxi Operators Association, says the transportation business is not a level playing field. He insists taxi operators and drivers are losing out to TNCs.
We are required to use a taximeter and our fares are regulated. TNVs are not required to have taximeters. They use their algorithm. They use dynamic pricing, meaning to say their fares may vary.
The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board is waiting for a law regulating TNCs. In the meantime, Senator Grace Poe, chairman of the Committee on Public Services, says the LTFRB can provide rules.
Marami naman silang pwedeng gawin. Halimbawa, sila na mismo nagsabi, kulang ang mga nagpo-provide ng service para sa mga pasahero. E di accredit na nila lahat ng mga wala namang problema sa accreditation papers nila. Dinggin na nila ang hinaing ng ating mga taxi drivers. Bigyan naman ninyo ng konting allowance yung kanilang pamasahe.
Mabibigay namin yung mga inputs namin so that they can craft a legislation that is really true to its form para sa mga TNVs.
There are 7 to 9,000 TNVs operating in every hour in Metro Manila. In September, the LTFRB will decide how many will be allowed to operate. Cecil Ardizabal, CNN Philippines.